Welcome again, and we are in the module 3 part 2 and VKit. I hope you are learning the management functions very well, and out of the 5 functions, that is planning, leading, organizing, controlling and staffing, today we will be talking about the controlling. Control is really important. If you are not controlling your organization, or as a man, if you are as a manager not applying the functions properly, then it can become an issue. You cannot control your performance, you cannot control your input, output or process. So let's talk about what is controlling and what are the tools you are going to use as a manager for a controlling. We will talk about a couple of tools after defining that process and initial definitions. So let's move on. Our key objective over here is to understand the controlling of organization performance and at 3 different levels. If you try to understand the control, managerial control, it is the process of monitoring activities to ensure that they are being accomplished as planned and of correcting any significant deviation. For example, you have a plan to develop a mobile application and it is not giving any error or any problem. So this is your success. For example, if you are targeting that this month Bank Muscat will generate 10,000 Omani Riyal as a revenue and without any deviation you achieve it, this means you have controlled it well. But you have planned it well as well. You are not planning under or over it. You are giving this performance indicator after well planning that this Sohar branch can easily generate a revenue of 10,000 Omani Riyal. Similarly, Sohar Aluminium, if it is there, you plan that you will produce at least 1 million ton of aluminium for this year. So this means you are planning properly, then you set a control properly. So this is the integration of your planning and controlling hands in hand. If you understand planning very well, then you can perform controlling very well. So you will always control something against the standardized input, standardized process, a standardized output. So the purpose of controlling is to ensure that the activities are accomplished in a way that leads to accomplish the organizational goals. Look, if the process is going well, your aluminium quality is very good, you are properly opening new bank accounts, or you are developing application. So you are actually contributing toward the organizational goals. So control help you and ensure that you are achieving it very well and as per standard. So why this control is important? Let's try to integrate it with some of other processes, and let's talk about this as the final link in the management functions. Means it is linked with the first planning. The controls let manager to know whether their goals and plans are on target and what future action need to be taken. If you achieve the goal, very good. How to improve them? If the goal or the process is not went well, then you will correct them and improve them. For example, you targeted to open 10 bank accounts in 1 month and you were able to manage only 5 bank accounts. Then you will talk to your team, sales team, and you will tell them that, look, we targeted 10 accounts, but we are able to open only 5. What to do? How we can improve this performance? So this is the way your plan will improve your through your feedback. So you will actually control will empower the employee. Controlling system provides manager with information and feedback on employee performance. If some employee is not performing well, then you can tell him that Mohammed or look Fatma, you are not performing well as a bank manager or as an accountant manager. What's wrong with you? Is there any problem at your family? Can we help you as an organization? Because if previously he was performing well, it's sudden, then you will try to help them. But if since last 6 months or 1 year, this is there is no performance in Muhammad or Fatma, then what you will do? You will may issue them a warning letter and ask them, look, I need to hire a new person. You are not performing well since last 1 year. And you will raise this complaint to the HR department. So controlling helps in protecting the workplace. Controls enhance physical security and help minimize the workplace disruption. For example, if someone is not coming on time and following this trend, the other 5 employees are also not coming in time, then it is a problem for overall department. So what you will do, you will set a control. Okay, please come on time. Be there on time. Don't try to misuse the time once you are there for your department. So this is the way you can see that the controlling function is really important. Now let's talk about as a process. The process, if you say you actually do three-step process, measuring actual performance, then you compare actual performance with the planned performance, then taking corrective action. So this process actually is a three-step process. Let's talk this process quickly, one by one. For example, first we will measure it through the planning. For example, you need to measure the performance with 10,000 Omani Rial revenue for the bank this month. Or 10,000 Omani Rial is the revenue for the Nesto or Lulu store this month. For the through selling of mobiles. So this is the way you are actually talking about how and what of the measure, how will be the source of the information and what will be the control criteria. For example, personal observation, statistical report, oral reports, written reports, that, for example, sales report, it is one of the report. If the sales is going down due to corona, you will talk to your team. So this is the source of information for you that due to corona, the sale is going down. So you will talk about this problem and you may talk about the online sales in this regard. So employees, turnover, budget, cost, and this will reflect what to do, what is the criteria to control. For example, how to control a sale. You will set a minimum standard and you will try to make employees satisfied, and you will, if you're talking about the employee performance and their absenteeism and if they are leaving the organization, these are the indicators that whether your HR department is overall working good or not. If if the employees are leaving again and again from the same department and you are unable to hold them with you, this means there is some problem maybe with the boss or with the HR department. You have to correct that problem. So similarly, the budget, cost and output and sales, these are the indicators how you will control and what you will control. Then you will perform the second step, that is called comparing. So you will actually determine the variation. For example, if you assume that 10,000 Omani Rial is the target sale with the variation of 5%. If it is going 20%, for example, it is 10,000 now, but it is just 5,000 is the sale, it is a 50% variation. Means suddenly drop down in a sale. So you are really worried. You can talk about this, and the comparing will help in this control process to improve the sale and talk about the problem of the sale in this situation. So then it is the taking the corrective action. Now there are three ways to correcting action. If the sale is proper during the corona even and improving, then you need not to do any action and you keep pushing your team in this situation, that is doing nothing. But if some performance is going down and sale is going down again and again, then you will take the corrective action. How you will correct it? For example, you may apply an online app for selling your products, mobiles and all those things. So the other way to improve the performance is to take the managerial action, is to revising the standard. For example, you may say that, okay, during corona or during this situation, we will reduce the sale target for this month for 5,000. But once this corona period will over, we will again target 10,000 sale, so that it will actually revise your standard for this. Similarly, if you are producing aluminium and initially the aluminium was on with the 1% error and it was being used for the computer chips, then in the next year you will say, okay, we have purchased new machines, now only 5% 0.5% error we will accept. Previously it was 1% error, now it will be 0.5%. This is the way you will correct and improve your performance, and you are actually revising your standards. So there are three types of controls on input, process and output. For the input, you actually apply the feed forward or the proactive approaches, mean you plan them very well before anything happen. The process is actually during the movement, the process is happening, you are developing the app and again customer feedback is coming and you are improving the system during the process. You are dealing with the client, okay, this problem happened, I will improve this module, this exception error, I will improve this. So during the process, you will keep improving and correcting. The output is once the performance is there, for example, your sale performance is there, then you will correct it next month by improving it or by revising it through different strategies which we have discussed previously. So this is these three types of controls are really important. This is all, and now we will talk about two type of the techniques you can apply. The first one is the MBO, the management by objective. This is a behavioral type of control. For example, you talk to your team, you agree with them for some of the organizational agreed objectives. For example, if you talk to faculty member, you tell them, okay, you will publish 2 articles in this year, and you will teach 14 or 12 or 10 credit hours this year. Or you talk to your Bank Muscat team and you say, okay, you agree with me to open 10 bank accounts each month. So you agreed with them some task, and now you try to, with the agreement of manager and the subordinate, you keep monitoring that performance with your sale team. So this is managed by objective. In step number one, you will be setting goals. Then you will be talking, manager and subordinate will be talking together in determining those goals. And finally, manager and their subordinate periodically review those goals, that whether you can open 10 bank accounts in a month, how was the performance for the March, now how will be in the April, March, and can you improve it, or can you maintain this average for the whole year, or some problem is happening. So you keep in reviewing this thing. So we will talk more detail about this MBO. And this last tool is the benchmarking. Normally it applies on the processes and the products only. So you actually take some standard. For example, the standard in your industry is to take the aluminium and produce with the 1% error. So you adopt that practice, best practice, which is your benchmark, and you try to produce the same aluminium at the standards. Similarly, if you produce some software, you think that not more than 3 or 4 exceptions should occur. Normally 3 exceptions are normal, and you capture them with some of your coding or anything, then this is the benchmarking or standard thing in this situation, and that is called benchmarking. So this is all for this lecture. Thank you everyone. I see you in the last part of this module 3. Assalamu alaikum.